Hey, Mama, are you feeling angry after childbirth and wondering why this is happening? Today, we're going to talk about the natural remedies that will help postpartum anger, as well as something called PMDD. By the end of this video, you'll have my tried and true herbal remedies for postpartum anger and something called PMDD, premenstrual dysphoric disorder, or really, really bad PMS. So let's get started. For the best natural remedies for women and children's health, hit the subscribe button and the bell to be notified of my new video each Tuesday. I've helped hundreds of women integrate natural remedies into their diet to reduce medications, and you can read more about my natural remedies on my blog post, tarajgregorio.com. Even if your period has not returned yet and you're postpartum and you're feeling this postpartum rage, I want you to think back before you had kids. How was your PMS? Was it really, really bad? And how can we change that going forward? So just to review, day one of your period is when you begin menstruating or bleeding. So day one is the blood. Day 14 is when you're ovulating. Now day 14 to 28 is typically when women have really bad PMS. And if the PMS is really bad, they correlate it, they call it PMDD, premenstrual dysphoric disorder. Now, in order for you to have PMDD, you have to have one of the following plus these other PMS symptoms. So listen up, do you have these symptoms? Number one, depression, mood, hopelessness. Number two, anxiety or this feeling that you're on edge, particularly between day 14 and day 28. Number three, sad, tearful, rejected. And number four, marked anger. So in order for you to have PMDD or postpartum rage, you wanna have one of those four symptoms, plus these other symptoms as well. Disinterest in activities, lack of energy, change in appetite, insomnia, out of control or overwhelm, and physical symptoms such as breast tenderness, headaches, bloating, and all of this probably affects your work, school, and other activities. So these symptoms, you would chart them for the next two consecutive months, and then that's categorized as something called PMDD. So when your menstruation comes back, if it hasn't come back already, your PMS may be really, really bad. So we're trying to get ahead of that by integrating herbal remedies and diet strategies right now. If your period already has returned and you're experiencing postpartum rage as well as PMS, then let's take care of it. We can do so by addressing your diet and integrating herbal remedies. So here are the five steps. Number one, eliminate or minimize coffee, alcohol, tobacco, and sugar. Now, I love my coffee as well, but you may notice day 14 to day 28, you have a harder time drinking the coffee. You may have more insomnia at night. And if you're having insomnia at night, the number one thing to take out is the caffeine. So what you can do is have a coffee early in the morning, or exchange that coffee for Dandy Blend or an alternative coffee solution, or even green tea because it's a great antioxidant. So taking out the coffee, or at least decreasing it, but particularly between day 14 and day 28, if your period has returned, because that will help reduce insomnia. Same thing with the alcohol. So a wine at night, moms will say they'll have a cup of coffee in the morning and wine at night. If you have that wine in the evening, it may interrupt your sleep, most likely, along with your children interrupting your sleep. It may interrupt your sleep. And the most important thing when you have postpartum rage, PMS, PMDD, or any anger is to sleep through the night. You need a good night's sleep. So that's the one thing we want to address. So you're removing things that are bothering your liver's ability to digest your food, to break down the hormones, especially postpartum, and especially during day 14 to day 28. So Eastern medicine believes this anger this particularly this postpartum anger has to do with our liver health. And the liver processes our hormones, and when it cannot do that, we tend to wake up at 2 or 3 a.m. and can't go back to sleep, or there's this intense anger that comes out of nowhere. So notice if that rings true to you. Number two, you can add in a hormone modulator called Vitex Chasteberry. Now, you would not want to do this if you're breastfeeding. So just double check if you're breastfeeding or not. It depends where you are and how far along you are postpartum. But Vitex Chasteberry can help modulate our hormones and reduce the anger, reduce the PMS, and reduce the PMDD. Chasteberry also decreases FSH and increases LH hormones, which decreases our estrogen and increases our progesterone. So taking Vitex Chasteberry has been known to reduce breast pain, swelling, bloating, headaches, and even constipation. How you would take it is 5 milliliters in the morning before your coffee. So it's similar to thyroid medication. You would purchase a tincture of Vitex Chasteberry. You would put about 5 milliliters in a 1/4 cup of water and drink that. And that would be your medicine for the morning. You may need up to 3 months to see some changes. Now, Vitex Chasteberry is very, very bitter, so you could add in other tinctures to make it taste better. Elderberry glycerite, lemon balm glycerite, or even just honey or maple syrup to get it down. But it is like taking a shot, and you do want to take it early in the morning before any other drinks or medications. In an adaptogen, have you used an adaptogen before? Put it in the comment area below, I'd love to know. Particularly ashwagandha is the number one searched adaptogen during breastfeeding. It's considered a class 1 or level 1 botanical while you're breastfeeding, so it's considered safe. And I would integrate it if you're having PMDD or postpartum rage. So ashwagandha can help reduce your stress and make it just a little bit easier. Adaptogens in general help us adapt around stress. So ashwagandha is number one because it's safest while you're breastfeeding, but there are other herbs that are considered adaptogens and can help give us energy and reduce our stress. Number four, you can add in an antidepressant, an herbal antidepressant. So if you're against medications or don't like to use them, the number one antidepressant medication is St. John's Wort. St. John's Wort is considered a level 3, class 3 herb if you're breastfeeding, so it's not the best herb to take when you're breastfeeding, but in extreme cases, if you didn't want to take medication and you needed something, it's something you may want to look into. If you're not breastfeeding and you're experiencing this rage, this PMS, this PMDD, I would highly suggest looking into and possibly integrating St. John's Wort. It is also the number one herb that does not match well with majority of the SSRIs. So if you're on antidepressant medication, again, check with your herbalist, check with your doctor. That is the number one herb-drug interaction for majority of medication. Number five is lifestyle. So often this PMS, this rage, this liver health has to do with suppressing our deepest desires. So move your body. Number one, move your body. Even if you don't feel like it, go for a walk, breathe, meditate. You've gotta move your body. Even if you're exhausted, sometimes the moving of the body just starts stirring things up. But just, it helps you and makes you feel better, especially with endorphins. So meditating has been the number one thing that has changed my mindset since having twins in 2013. So every time they would go for a nap, when I was able to time it at the same time, I would turn on and just do breathing for 10 minutes. I would turn on my phone and just do breathing for 10 minutes. And then I started following guided meditations. You can watch this video to see my favorite guided meditations. After your meditation, journaling, writing as much as you can, artwork, you're trying to tap into your feminine self. Anything artistic, creative, knitting, writing, drawing, these are all self-care, self-nourishing practices that women need to integrate into their life to embrace their feminine self and to connect with your deeper self. And why is this anger coming up for you? The other reason this is happening is you may be on a blood sugar roller coaster. And what that means is that you've got caffeine in the morning, wine at night, and sugar throughout the day. So your blood sugar is doing this up and down. What you want to think about is incorporating a little bit of protein and healthy fat at every meal for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Think of avocados, olive oil, even butter, and trying to get really good proteins in to keep your blood sugar steady throughout the day. So now that you know why you're having postpartum anger or even PMS and PMDD, download my free checklist to get to the root cause of any anxiety you're experiencing. If you like this video, if it helped you, please hit the subscribe button, share it with a girlfriend, and comment below and tell me your number one takeaway from the video. Thank you.